Has Bellamy Young started a music career? Why did Scott Foley's Whiskey Cavalier get canceled? What sport has Tony Goldwyn spent the last 40 years mastering? I'm Vivica, and welcome to the OSA Special Report on Where is the Cast of Scandal Now? Melly has proven that she earned it all through hard work, just like Bellamy in real life. Her character, Arch, was initially minor, written for 3 episodes, but she proved that Melly Grant can pull off much more. And of course, hats off to Shonda Rhimes for writing one of the strongest character monologues delivered by Bellamy. It's only been a year since Bellamy left Scandal, but she's already knee-deep in a number of projects. In 2018, she starred in the science fantasy adventure film A Wrinkle in Time, alongside Reese Witherspoon, Zach Galifianakis, Chris Pine, and Oprah Winfrey. And you better make sure you have some water with you, because it's about to get hot in here. And the heat comes from the totally flaming reviews from critics. But don't worry, around halfway into the movie, things cool down a little when we see giant flying lettuce on our screens, which was just brought in to exhibit some amazing CGI, which was just about all the movie could deliver. After the filming ended, Bellamy tried her hand in the horror thriller Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark, produced by Academy Award winner Guillermo del Toro. And this fact is highlighted in the trailer 3 times. We will also get a glimpse of Bellamy in Heartstrings, the Dolly Parton anthology web television series on Netflix, where each of the 8 episodes is based on one of her songs. While Bellamy's Instagram is about work, 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 more work, we still managed to spot a couple of pics of her hugging drummer Pedro Segundo. In 2015, Bellamy released her first album, Far Away So Close, on iTunes. The 10-song album includes cover songs from Pink to Fleetwood Mac. We're just waiting for her next album, Sugar So Salty and Moon So Sunny. So perhaps the two met while recording Young's album? The intimate photos suggest they may be dating, though they haven't issued any official statements yet. Now, some breaking news about Jeff Perry, aka Cyrus Bean, a man that on the one hand dreams, eats, and breathes DC politics, and on the other hates kids, is finally off the screen. Anyway, while Scandal was coming to an end in 2018, Jeff Perry was already filling up his portfolio faster than Cyrus Bean was sabotaging his friends. Jeff starred in TV series Dirty John, one more inspiring stalker story that aired on February 14th. He also had a 3-episode-long role on the series $1. To quote IMDb, a $1 bill changing hands connects a group of characters involved in a shocking multiple murder. Besides his latest show, Jeff still makes appearances on Grey's Anatomy and enjoys occasional lunch dates with the rest of the Scandal cast, since almost all of them have appeared on that medical drama series. In 2018, Perry pleased his fans by playing a leading role in the short movie Unintended, which is the story of what happens when a woman's unintended actions lead her to an encounter with a damaged stranger. If any of you know what happens when a woman meets a stranger, the comments section is available 24/7. Our script writers are standing by. So if you have any creative information, please share. Jeff is now 63 and enjoys his life with his wife of 30 years, Linda, who is also a Grey's Anatomy casting director. Speaking of Shondaland, we now move on to Tony Goldwyn. Turns out running the country doesn't necessarily mean thinking with your head, right, President Goldwyn? Too bad we can't have him here to comment on that. Even though there were fans protesting that Olivia should have ended up with Jake instead of Fitz, Tony Goldwyn himself says he always knew that the characters were meant to be together. Now, when asked about the unexpected ending scene between Jake and Liv and what he thinks the characters could be doing a year later, Goldwyn says, "My instinct about Fitz and Olivia was they would have probably gone to Vermont and Olivia would have spent about 48 hours in Vermont and said, 'Get me the hell out of here.' But what is Tony Goldwyn himself doing a year later? Here's what our team has found after a special one-day-long investigation on the internet. After the series finale, Goldwyn switched to the horror genre, starring in the supernatural horror series Chambers that premiered on Netflix this April. Tony plays the role of a grieving father, alongside his on-screen wife, Uma Thurman, whose daughter died and had her heart transplanted into another teenage girl named Sasha. Now, Sasha sees and feels the things that her donor was going through, and they are extremely terrifying. The show has great suspense and tension to keep the audience glued to their screens. Unfortunately, Netflix is not going to greenlight season 2. Now on to some sports news. Tony Goldwyn began jogging 37 years ago and continues to do so to this day. Turns out the simple daily routine was inspired by a life-changing event. Almost 40 years ago, Tony was the wingman to his friend who was obsessed with Goldwyn's current wife, Jane Muskie. The three of them would go running together until one day it was just Tony and Jane who went for a run. Well, Goldwyn may not have won a marathon, but he definitely got the prize. While Tony technically didn't steal his friend's girlfriend, Jake Ballard did steal Olivia. Running the Black Ops Team B613 and spying on Olivia didn't exactly bode well for his karma. But the moment we see him with Olivia, we begin to feel that she is a much better person when she's with him. Absolutely different from how she acts with Fitz. Even though Jake made some controversial decisions, he's still one of the show's favorites, just like Scott Foley, who portrays him. Storylines built around criminal justice undoubtedly suit Foley, so after the Scandal series ended, Scott joined one more crime series. Now, to be accurate, action, comedy, drama series. Foley played a leading character on ABC series Whiskey Cavalier alongside the gorgeous Lauren Cohan. Unfortunately, the show is too reminiscent of ABC's other criminal comedy drama series Castle. Though the plot is different, Scott plays an FBI agent opposite Cohan's character, a CIA agent, saving the world, the character arc is similar to the one Castle had. Friendship, romance, and office politics are still on the table. That's not to mention the never-ending game of finding out who is superior between the two. Now, by the way, if that mention of Castle made you feel a little nostalgic, why don't you look back on the cast of the series in our video, which reveals where they are now. We're guessing that the audience saw the similarities as well, and that's why ratings dropped dramatically. The show was canceled after just one season. For now, Scott doesn't have any other major projects that we know of. Well, that means he'll have enough time to spend with his three kids and Marika, his wife of 12 years, an actress in her own right. Back in the early 2000s, Scott was married to another actress, Jennifer Garner, but the couple broke up 3 years later, with Jennifer stating that they didn't have a chance. Though Scott is a good guy, the relationship just imploded. The last one on our list today is Kerry Washington. If all celebs had Olivia Pope as their life crisis manager, Hollywood reporters would be out of a job for sure. Kerry was undoubtedly fantastic in her role as a strong, get-it-done woman saves the day in the White House. But besides her most recognizable character of Olivia Pope, Kerry has pulled off one more, perhaps even more outstanding role in HBO's political thriller film Confirmation in 2016. The film tells the story of Clarence Thomas's Supreme Court nomination hearings after Anita Hill alleged he sexually harassed her. Kerry plays Hill alongside a stunning Wendell Pierce, aka Robert Zane from Suits, Jeffrey Wright, and Erica Jane Christensen. After Olivia was done with playing her role in Scandal, she joined the superstar cast of celebs for a live in front of a studio audience with Norman Lear's All in the Family and the Jeffersons playing Helen Willis. If you just think about the generally negative reviews that critics gave Fuller House and the reboots of MacGyver and 90210, you might understand why we weren't expecting things to turn out so well, but they definitely exceeded our expectations. After great success in front of the live audience, Kerry jumped right into working on her next project, the movie Little Fires Everywhere, that's in pre-production now and coming out next year. Kerry also tried out the role of producer on the teen drama series 5 Points. That's impressive. But in between filming, Kerry still finds the time to bond with her husband and raise 3 kids. And this is the OSA Scandal Report for today. I'm Vivica, and thank you for staying awesome.